Okay, very good afternoon, one and all. I hope all are here. Am I audible? Am I audible? Okay, I suppose I am audible. Right, let me continue. Okay, so we are starting with our second semester from now. In the last class, I have given you all the important instruction which you need to follow regarding your second semester. So I'll be starting with unit number 6. Why? Because this carries 15 marks and it is having numericals. Two sets of numericals have been there. So I thought of going with the bigger unit in the first part so that the smaller unit may be covered in the later classes easily. Okay. So in this unit, what is there? So water treatment, some of the part you have done in your 11th and 12th standard. So I'll just be brushing up with all those part and the one which has been important from your examination point, I'll be giving stress onto it. Okay. So let us begin unit that is water treatment. This is unit number 6. So we all know that without water, nothing is possible. So we can say ki water is marvelous. It is beautiful. It is creative, it is destructive as well. Why I'm been saying beautiful? Beautiful, matlab, when you see a water body, it calms your mind, right? I'm saying it is marvelous. Marvelous is because it is universal solvent. It can take up anything. Everything has been dissolved into it. Almost everything can be dissolved into it. Okay, then I have said creative. Why I have used the word creative? Because life originated into water. The first life originated into water. Then water is very much important for all the living human beings, be it animal or be it plant or be it a human being. Without water, we cannot think of our life. And I have used the word destructive. Why destructive? Because see, you have seen the fury, the furious nature of water also. When it goes out of your control, we see flood, right? Then if there is no water, you see drought. So water is the most wonderful nature's gift to us and we need to preserve it from our side. Okay, so with this quote without food, human can survive for a number of days, but without water, which is an essential commodity, you can say, we cannot survive. So although water is nature's most wonderful, beautiful, marvelous, abundant gift, given to us, but it is one of the most misused one. So we need to see to it ki we how we can contribute from our side. I'm not asking you to just go open and teach everyone. No need to teach anyone. Just do your bit. Automatically everything comes up and it becomes very good. Okay, so something went wrong. Let me begin it again. Fine. So the next part is the content of the unit. So what is there? We have to go with the hardness of water, types of hardness. With that, I'll be teaching you the pH also, the importance of pH, right? How it has been calculated. Domestic water treatment, we'll be going with the brief discussion regarding coagulation sterilization using various techniques. Breakpoint chlorination is new word to you. We'll go with the softening of water, in which we'll be studying about the principle, reaction, advantages, limitations. And we are going to compare lime soda, zeolite and demineralization process. In detail, we need to study about demineralization process only. Zeolite and demineralization process, we'll be studying this in detail. We'll just talk about lime soda process. Then we have boiler troubles, why it is being caused. And in detail, we are going to study about what scales and sludges. Then we are going to study about boiler corrosion. And I'm just going to talk about internal conditioning verbally, nothing more in detail in this. Then you need to solve the numerical based on zeolite. And with that, we need to do the numerical based on hardness also. So we'll take care of that also. Then desalination of brackish water through electrodialysis and reverse osmosis process. And wastewater treatment, introduction and importance. And we'll see to it ki we have to go with the membrane process also. So we'll talk about that in the later classes. and no doubt there will be just idea about how the various wastewater treatment is being carried out. Now let us begin with the introductory part. That water is a chemical substance having a formula of H2O. Sabhi ko pata hai, right? Then a water molecule contains one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms connected by which bond? Covalent bond. Please remember this word. It is covalent bond. So water is a liquid at ambient condition, right? But it often exists on Earth with its solid state like ice, in its gaseous state like water vapor or steam. We know Earth is known as blue planet. Why it has been known as blue planet? Because roughly 87 to 97% of the water is being like, or the Earth has been covered with water. Henceforth, Earth is known as blue planet. Now let us talk about the sources of water. So there are various sources of water. Okay, bahut sare sources hai, and it has been classified into two categories, mainly the surface sources and the subsurface sources or the underground sources. Those may classify karenge surface sources and underground sources, which is also been known as subsurface sources. So in surface sources we have n number of examples that are that can be classified as or can be said as ponds, lakes, streams and rivers. Then we have storage reservoirs, which has been built up by man. Okay, then oceans. Generally, we do not use ocean, and this water is because it is very much salty. So we are not been using it for drinking purposes. But yes, some of the sea water can be used for cooling purposes also. But nowadays, since the water is being scarce, henceforth we are been moving toward desalination of salty water. Desalination means we are going to remove the salt from the water so that the water become fit for drinking, and then we can use it for drinking purpose. Okay, so the other classification is subsurface or underground, in which we can call as, can give the examples of springs, infiltration well and wells and tube wells. Theek hai, fine. So classification kaisa karenge, do tarah se karenge. Okay, so subsurface and underground sources. Then there is one of the source, that is the rainwater source. I haven't written here, but you can also write down one of the major sources of all these is nothing but the rainwater. Okay, so we can say ki rainwater is the purest source of water. Aapka ek mark ka question hota hai, which is the purest source of water? Rainwater is the purest source of water. Why it is so purest source of water? Because it has been obtained by the process of evaporation, condensation, right? Evaporation and condensation. Please remember these two words, evaporation and condensation. Okay, evaporation and condensation. Aapko ye yaad rakhna hai, dono words. So, ye basic ho gaya aapke raw water sources. Now let's talk about the distribution of water. See, this much is the ocean. Can you see? Ocean. Then uske baad kaun aata hai? Glaciers and polar ice. Then comes the underground water. Then comes the river. Then comes the atmosphere. And the last one comes the biosphere. So for your knowledge, I'll be just stating you that roughly 0.5% of the fresh water is being available to us for drinking purpose. 0.5%. And this much percent of water is being available for it's a fresh water, okay, and this has been available for all sorts of activities. Kaun kaun se activities hogi? Domestic activities ho jati hain, uske baad aapki ho jati industrial activities, aur uske baad ho jati hain aapki agricultural activities. Theek hai? So this much fresh water is being utilized for all these activities, and I'll tell you ki the amount of water which has been required for agriculture is more, it is the most as compared to domestic and industrial. So for around for manufacturing or for just growing food for one person, we need to have almost 3000 liters of water per head. Just imagine how much amount of water the agriculture is requiring. And without agriculture, again, food is important, we cannot survive. So water is very much essential. Okay, let's talk about water quality. So when we talk about water, now we get water from various sources, and you know ki there are two types of sources I have explained you. So we have salty water and fresh water. Acha, before this I just wanted to tell you, you see oceans, it's salty water, so we are not been using glaciers and polar ice. Fresh water hi hai ye, but we cannot use it. Why we cannot use it? Because it is in the form of ice, and if we wanted to use this water, we need to give heat so that it melts, and then we'll get the fresh water. But this process becomes very much costly. Fine. So underground water भी हमको सब चीज अवेलेबल नहीं है ना, बहुत सारी ऐसी जगह अंडरग्राउंड वाटर है जहां पर हम रीच ही नहीं कर सकते, हम पहुंच ही नहीं सकते. दे आर वेरी मच डीप, वी कैन नॉट रीच देयर. सो जहां तक हम पहुंच सकते हैं वो पानी निकाल सकते हैं और ले सकते हैं. अगेन अंडरग्राउंड वाटर निकालना इज नॉट अ इजी टास्क, वी नीड टू गो विद द बोरिंग, वी नीड टू डिग वेल, राइट. सो it again becomes very much costly. Lakes and rivers, yes, it is available to us, we can use it. Atmosphere का water we cannot use because it is dispersed in the atmosphere, so you cannot think of it. And biosphere is nothing but the total atmosphere in which the fresh water has been available. So हमारे पास पानी जो available है वो किसका है? Lakes का है and underground है. उसमें से भी मैं total आपको average बता दिया मैंने, 0.5% of the water has been available for all the applications or you can say all the work which human person does. और ऐसा कोई भी काम नहीं है जिसमें पानी नहीं लगता, हर एक काम में यू रिक्वायर वाटर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द क्वालिटी ऑफ द वाटर, बिकॉज सी वाटर के सोर्सेज अलग अलग हैं. सो द सोर्सेज ऑफ वाटर इज डिफरेंट, सो द वाटर क्वालिटी विल बी डिफरेंट. ओके, जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू रिमाइंड यू, अराउंड 41 स्टूडेंट अलॉन्ग इंक्लूडिंग मी, दैट मीन्स 40 स्टूडेंट्स आर वॉचिंग नाउ this lecture, and I have a class strength of around 120. And how come the attendance has been for 100%? So I wanted everyone to be here in my class. So I'll be keeping a track on your this comment on live chat, right? Now you need to put your comment, and aapka comment kab denge? Jab main bolungi tab comment kar dena hai, aur gayab nahi hone ka, yahi rehne ka hai. Theek hai? And then you need to fill up the which the form, and I can see the comment, the time, everything I can see here. Now continuing with the water quality, so there are various water qualities which you need to keep, right? Depending upon the type of the water or whatever you can say composition it contains, on that basis we'll think of it where it has to be used. So the raw, the treated water, raw water means the water which has been available in nature. रॉ वाटर, ओके. ट्रीटेड मतलब जैसे हमें एनएमसी से पानी मिलता है, सो दैट इज ट्रीटेड वाटर. सो वट एवर वाटर यू गेट देयर इन द रिवर और इन द पॉन्ड्स और इन द लेक्स, वो हम डायरेक्टली नहीं पी रहे हैं, याद रखिएगा. सो जो रिवर, लेक्स एंड आपका डैम में जो पानी रहता है, हम उसको पी नहीं पाएंगे क्योंकि वो गंदा है, उसमें मिट्टी होगी या उसमें डर्ट होगी या उसमें बैक्टीरियल ग्रोथ होगी. सो दैट वाटर इज बीन टेकन अप बाई द म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन, देन दे ट्रीट इट अकॉर्डिंगली. After going through the analysis of the water, they treat it accordingly, and the treated water reaches us through various pipelines. Agreed? So this raw water, ye do word ka aapko dhyan mein rakhna. When I use the word raw water, it means it has been obtained directly from the nature or from the environment or from the surroundings. And when I say treated water, this means ki it has been treated. Koi na koi process usme kiya gaya hai. It can be chlorination, it can be filtration, any process. Ek bhi process ho gaya, matlab usko hum kya bolenge? Treated water. So it has to be tested, it has to be analyzed for their physical, chemical and bacterial characteristics. Because we are drinking water, if anything is present into it, it is going to harm not only to one person but to the whole city or to everyone, है ना. जिनका इम्यूनिटी कम होगा सबको तकलीफ होगी. सो म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन टेक केयर्स ऑफ दिस मैटर. सो दे वॉट दे डू, दे ट्रीट द वॉटर एंड देन दे गिव इट टू अस. सो देर आर सर्टन फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, बहुत डिटेल में नहीं जाना है आपको. आपको ये याद इसलिए रखना है बिकॉज दिस विल बी आस्ड इन योर एग्जामिनेशन, इन योर प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन. सो मेजोरिटी ऑफ योर प्रैक्टिकल दिस ईयर, दिस सेमेस्टर इज बेस्ड ऑन वाटर, राइट. वाटर क्वालिटी, वाटर पैरामीटर्स. सो यू नीड टू हैव बिट आइडिया regarding all those parameters. So let's talk about the physical characteristics. They are turbidity, color, taste and odor, temperature, and what about the chemical characteristics? It is pH. Acha, ye sab to theek hai. Okay, fine, temperature normal hona chahiye, taste nahi hona chahiye, usme odor nahi hona chahiye, color nahi hona chahiye. Turbidity matlab What do you mean by turbidity? Turbidity is मटमैला बोलते हैं ना पानी, जैसे इन रेनी सीजन यू गेट टर्बिड वाटर इन टैप ऑल्सो. सो इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ विच इम्प्योरिटी, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ कोलॉइडल इम्प्योरिटीज. याद रखिएगा, टर्बिडिटी इज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ कोलॉइडल इम्प्योरिटीज. प्लीज मार्क दिस, ये क्वेश्चन आएगा. It is because of the presence of colloidal impurities. We'll talk about the various impurities afterwards. Okay. So chemical characteristics mein kya hai? pH. So we'll be talking about pH tomorrow, not today. Tomorrow we'll be talking about pH. So we have pH. We have alkalinity. I'll be talking about this alkalinity as well. It is there in your exam practical. So abhi brief padhaungi, practical mein detail mein padhenge. Acidity. Then hardness. We'll be talking about this also in detail today itself. Then we have sulfates, presence of sulfate, presence of iron, solids, so on and so forth, right? Nitrates, okay? Then we have bacterial characteristics. So bacterial, why I've been giving stress on this? Because this is the one which indicates a degree of pollution. If there is larger amount of bacterial growth seen in the water body, that means the water body is highly polluted, okay? So water polluted, कैसा होगा वाटर पोल्यूशन? इट इज बीन बाय द एडिशन ऑफ सीवेज, राइट? अब सीवेज कहाँ से आएगा? कहीं से भी सीवेज आ सकता है. सीवेज विच इज बीन डम्प्ड इनटू द वाटर बॉडी एंड इट मे कंटेन वन और मोर स्पीशीज ऑफ डिजीज प्रोड्यूसिंग पैथोजेंस. व्हेन आई यूज द वर्ड डिजीज प्रोड्यूसिंग, आई विल बी ओनली यूजिंग पैथोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया. बिकॉज बैक्टीरियाज दो तरह के होते हैं, गुड बैक्टीरिया एंड बैड बैक्टीरिया. गुड बैक्टीरियाज आर गुड फॉर योर हेल्थ, है ना, दे वोंट कॉज एनी हार्मफुल इफेक्ट ऑन टू द ह्यूमन. वेयर एज पैथोजेंस, दे आर द बैक्टीरियाज जिनकी आदत ही होती है वो सब कुछ बीमारी में डालना है, इसको तकलीफ देना. सो वेन आई यूज द वर्ड पैथोजन बैक्टीरिया या पैथोजेनिक इम्प्योरिटीज, इट मीन्स दीज आर नथिंग बट दी स्पीशीज ऑफ अ बैक्टीरिया विच प्रोड्यूसेस डिजीजेज इन ह्यूमन बींग. अगेन प्लीज मार्क दिस वर्ड पैथोजेनिक, दिस इज न्यू वर्ड एंड यू मस्ट हैव studied this in the previous class as well. Now pathogenic bacteria your organism, they causes what? Waterborne diseases. Okay, तो maximum हमें जो stomach alignment होते हैं या stomach की जो बीमारियां होती हैं, stomach infections जो होते हैं, it is because we go or we drink the water or we eat food which is basically like contaminated or which is having certain bacterial growth into it. And there are many non-pathogenic bacteria, for example E. coli. So which is a member of coliform group, also lives in the intestinal tract of human being and this helps in the digestion as well. See, coliform itself is not harmful group, but it has more resistance to adverse condition than any other group. So if it has been is ensured to minimum the number of coliform, the harmful species will be very less. So coliform jo family hai na, jo group hai, wo nuksandeh nahi hai. लेकिन उसमें से कुछ कुछ जो है ना वो दे आर रियली वेरी वेरी हार्मफुल. सो वी नीड टू बी वेरी मच केयरफुल विद द बैक्टीरियोलॉजिकल इम्प्योरिटीज. सो कोलिफॉर्म ग्रुप बेसिकली सर्व्स एज एन इंडिकेटर फॉर कंटामिनेशन ऑफ वाटर एंड सीवेज एंड द प्रेजेंस ऑफ पैथोजेंस. सो वी नीड टू सी टू इट कि द वाटर विच वी आर गोइंग टू गेट शुड बी फ्री फ्रॉम बैक्टीरियल इम्प्योरिटीज एज वेल. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द इम्प्योरिटीज. ठीक है, सो देर आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ इम्प्योरिटीज. सो लेट अस क्लासिफाई देम. दे हैव बीन क्लासिफाइड इन टू थ्री टाइप. फिजिकल इम्प्योरिटीज, लाइक फिजिकल में हम बात करते हैं सस्पेंडेड इम्प्योरिटीज. सस्पेंडेड यानी कि जो हमारी आंखें देख रही हैं, देख सकती हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई पुट अ रॉक, सो आई कैन सी. सो रॉक को मैं आसानी से देख के निकाल सकती हूँ. सो दैट इज फिजिकल इम्प्योरिटीज. देन इफ आई पुट लीफ, पत्ती डाल दिया मैंने, तो दैट इज एन सस्पेंडेड इम्प्योरिटी जो फ्लोट कर रही है, निकाल सकते हैं. इफ आई हैव एडेड अ ट्विग, ट्विग मतलब लकड़ी का टुकड़ा, है ना. सो दीज आर व्हाट ऑल सस्पेंडेड इम्प्योरिटीज, दे कैन इजीली बी रिमूव्ड, राइट. देन वी हैव कोलॉइडल इम्प्योरिटीज. आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस, मैंने पहले भी बोला है, दिस इज बीन रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉजिंग व्हाट. क्या कॉज करता है कोलॉइडल इम्प्योरिटीज? दिस इज बीन responsible for causing the muddiness of the water basically. So this impurities has to be removed, should be taken care of. As I told you, okay, this causes you can say the water becomes very much muddy in nature. So what are colloidal impurities? These are the impurities which are basically charged in nature. What are they? They are charged, they are not very big, not very small, so they do not settle on their own. So you have to add on some chemicals to it so that we remove all the colloidal impurities. You must have heard about the word alum and fitkari. Yes. So we use alum to remove what? Colloidal impurities. Fine. Then we have the chemical impurities, in which we can say dissolved salts, dissolved gases, and the third one we can think of as bacterial impurities. So just summing up everything, so impurities have been classified into three: physical impurities, then we have the chemical impurities, and then we have what? The bacterial impurities. Physical impurities has been subclassified as suspended and colloidal, right? Chemical impurities has been classified as dissolved gases and dissolved salts. Chemical impurities mein dissolved salts ki agar aap baat karte hain, to you can think of CaCl2 calcium chloride, right? Then you can think of CaCO3 calcium carbonate. We hardness mein aata hai CaCO3. Okay. When I use the word dissolved gases, sari gases aa jati hain pani mein dissolve. CO2 bol sakte hain aap. Then you can talk of O2 also, right? We can say H2S gas is also been there in dissolved state. Okay. See? So jo suspended impurities hai, jaise humne aapko pehle bhi bataya, ki they are basically clay, mud, algae, industrial waste, organic matter, and they can be easily removed by a simple sedimentation process. So suspended impurities ko nikalne ke liye sedimentation process karna padta hai. Okay. Let's talk about the impurities in general and how it can be removed. Ek pura brush up karna hai. Suspended impurities bola maine, dissolved impurities bola, colloidal impurities and biological impurities. Okay, suspended mein humne example diya clay, mud, organic matter ka. Fine. Then dissolved impurities mein I have given example of either gases or salts. Colloidal impurities nothing but again clay, organic particles or organic matter, mud, which is basically having charge over it. प्लीज मार्क दोज वर्ड चार्ज. बताऊंगी क्यों. बायोलॉजिकल में देख लेंगे एल्गी, फंजाई, बैक्टीरिया. यस. ओके. नाउ सस्पेंडेड इम्प्योरिटीज अगर पानी में रहेगी तो आप उसको कैसे निकाल सकते हैं? यू कैन ईजिली रिमूव बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ फिल्ट्रेशन. फिल्ट्रेशन यानी कि एक कुछ फिल्टर लगा देते हैं वहाँ पर एंड ऑटोमेटिकली थिंग्स आर रिमूव्ड. यहाँ पर एक और चीज़ है, बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेडिमेंटेशन वी कैन रिमूव द सस्पेंडेड इम्प्योरिटीज. मेजोरिटी ऑफ द सस्पेंडेड इम्प्योरिटीज आर रिमूव बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेडिमेंटेशन. Sedimentation, mentation, sedimentation. Okay, you can easily remove by this suspended impurities by sedimentation. What is sedimentation? एक बीकर लेंगे, उसमें सारी impurity, ये जो पानी डाल देंगे उसमें. ओके. सब ऐसे स्प्रेड करा हुआ रहेगा इम्प्योरिटीज, उसको छोड़ देंगे अनडिस्टर्ब फॉर हाफ एन आवर, वन आवर, थ्री आवर, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द वाटर. एंड थोड़ी बात देखेंगे तो क्या होगा, सारी इम्प्योरिटीज है वो धीरे धीरे अपने आप सेडिमेंट हो जाती है नीचे, एंड देन यू कैन रिमूव द ऊपर से पानी पूरा निकाल देंगे. फाइन. देन टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिजॉल्व इम्प्योरिटीज, अभी डिजॉल्व इम्प्योरिटीज जो रहती है ना, इनको आसानी से नहीं निकाल सकते, उसके लिए हमें कहीं ना कहीं केमिकल प्रोसेसेस यूज करने पड़ेंगे. सो इफ यू वांटेड टू रिमूव द डिजॉल्व इम्प्योरिटीज, यू गो विद द प्रोसेस ऑफ सॉफ्टनिंग. ये हम पढ़ेंगे डिटेल में आगे. ओके. सो मैंने आपको एग्जाम्पल दे दी, जैसे कि CO2 है, उसको रिमूव करना है तो वी हैव मेनी वेज. पढ़ना है डिटेल में आगे, इसलिए आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट हियर. देन लाइम सोडा प्रोसेस है, ठीक है, लाइम सोडा प्रोसेस है. देन वी हैव जियोलाइट प्रोसेस हियर, देन वी हैव आयन एक्सचेंज प्रोसेस. तो हमको वो सब यहाँ करना है. टॉकिंग अबाउट colloidal impurities, आई हैव यूज दिस वर्ड, वी कैन ईजिली रिमूव बाई द प्रोसेस ऑफ कोएगुलेशन. मैंने एग्जाम्पल आपको बता भी दिया एलम. ओके. सो because they are charged particles, so we need to have a medium through which we can easily precipitate them out. Next is biological impurities. This can be removed by the process of sterilization, hai na. Pani ko hum jaise usually abhi to kar nahi karte, earlier in the when we were very small, nowadays we have all the filters and all na, bade bade aqua guard, this and that sab aage, to we need not boil the water. But earlier jab hum seedha tap ka pani peete the na, to our mother used to boil the water for us इन रेनी सीजन, स्पेशली इन रेनी सीजन. अदरवाइज बाकी के मैं सीजन्स में, बाकी के ईयर में तो हम लोग पानी घड़े का ही पिया करते थे. बट नाउ वी हैव ऑल दिस एक्वा गार्ड्स, RO. एंड लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग हियर, द वाटर ऑफ RO इज नॉट एट ऑल गुड फॉर योर हेल्थ. I'm not the one who is using RO. I use simple filtration because I know what are the repercussions. So I have all, like, I've been using my knowledge here, my chemistry knowledge here. Okay. So this biological impurities can be easily removed by the process of sterilization. Here we require a sterilizing agent. Okay. Like chlorine, ozone, or UV light. Detail mein aage padhenge isko bhi. Now let us talk about the you can say the type of impurities which has been there in the groundwater or in the surface water. In the groundwater, underground water mein kya hota? Dekho, high mineral content rahega. Kyun rahega high mineral content? Because pani jo rehta na, rain water, it percolates and then it is like it gets accumulated under the groundwater level. Aapne padha hoga na, underground mein level rehta hai. वहाँ पर इट गेट्स अक्यूमुलेटेड सो ऑटोमेटिक जब पर्कुलेशन होगा तो एज आई टोल्ड यू कि वाटर इज अ वेरी गुड सॉल्वेंट सो इट इज गोइंग टू डिसॉल्व ऑल द मिनरल कंटेंट हुएवर कम्स इन इट्स वे एंड इट गेट्स अक्यूमुलेटेड देयर राइट सो इट इज हैविंग हाई मिनरल कंटेंट लो ऑर्गेनिक लेवल दैट मीन्स सी इट इज गोइंग डाउन सो एक लेवल तक ही ऑर्गेनिक मैटर आपको मिलेगा उसके बाद आपको ऑर्गेनिक मैटर नहीं मिलेगा सो यू विल सी लो लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कॉम्पोनेंट्स देन यू हैव यू विल सी हाई लेवल ऑफ हार्डनेस वाई बिकॉज हाई मिनरल कंटेंट इज देयर सो यू आर गोइंग टू सी हाई लेवल ऑफ हार्डनेस एंड देन लेस टेम्परेचर वेरिएशन है ना फाइन जमीन के अंदर टेम्परेचर वेरिएशन ज्यादा नहीं होता बिकॉज सनलाइट डज नॉट पेनीट्रेट हेंस फोर देर इज वेरी लेस टेम्परेचर वेरिएशन ओके बट वेर एज वी टॉक अबाउट सर्फेस वाटर वी सी लोअर मिनरल कंटेंट क्यों क्योंकि पानी जो है ना फ्लोट होता जा रहा है तो मिनरल कंटेंट क्या इट वेरीज फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस देन इट विल बी हैविंग हाई ऑर्गेनिक लेवल येस बिकॉज इट इज फ्लोटिंग इन नेचर ना तो कहीं ना कहीं से पूरा ऑर्गेनिक मैटर अक्यूमुलेट होकर वो फ्लोट होता हुआ जा रहा है सो जहाँ पर रिवर खत्म होती है तो वहाँ पर सबसे ज्यादा ऑर्गेनिक कंटेंट आपको मिलेगा बिकॉज वो अक्यूमुलेशन पॉइंट हो जाएगा ओके देन इट विल बी हैविंग हाई डिसॉल्व सॉलिड लेवल वाई बिकॉज पूरा रेन वाटर्स जो है ना वो बहता हुआ कहाँ जाके मिलेगा आपका रिवर्स एंड सी में तो टोटल डिसॉल्व कंटेंट TDS जिसको हम बोलते हैं TDS वो क्या रहेगा इसमें हाई रहेगा एंड नो डाउट इट विल बी हैविंग वाइड टेम्परेचर वेरिएशन जो ऊपर की लेयर रहेगी वाटर की वो थोड़ी सी गर्म रहेंगी जैसे जैसे आप नीचे की तरफ जाएंगे तो वो थोड़ी ठंडी होगी और फिर नीचे फिर से वो गर्म हो जाएगी so you will see a wide range of temperature. अभी मैं ऐसा बोली थी जैसे रिवर है ये सर्फेस है तो यहाँ का पानी विल बी दिस द टेम्परेचर ऑफ दिस वाटर विल बी रफली सेम एज दैट ऑफ द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द एटमोसफियर येस सो एज यू गो डाउन तो धीरे धीरे ये क्या होगा ठंडा होगा यहाँ नॉर्मल हो जाएगा बीच में एंड देन अगेन यहाँ पर सर्फेस जो है ना अर्थ सर्फेस के पास जैसा टेम्परेचर रहेगा ना उसका यहाँ रहेगा तो इट यू कैन से इट इंक्रीजेस फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस यहाँ सबसे कम रहेगा और यहाँ सबसे ज़्यादा रहेगा वाइस वर्सा में भी तक कंडीशन डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दी वेदरिक टेम्परेचर लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वर्ड हार्डनेस ये हम 11th में पढ़े हैं शायद 11th या 12th में ओके सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट हार्डनेस व्हाट इज हार्डनेस इट इज नथिंग बट द सोप कंज्यूमिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ वाटर क्या है ये सोप कंज्यूमिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ वाटर सो हार्डनेस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सॉल्ट्स विथ सॉल्ट्स कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम सॉल्ट याद रखना है कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम सॉल्ट ओके फाइन सो हार्डनेस इज नथिंग बट द सोप कंज्यूमिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ वाटर If water produces lather with soap, it is soft water. If it does not produce lather with soap, it is known as hard water. तो पानी दो तरह के हो सकते हैं soft water and hard water. Soft water वो जिसमें lathering of soap हो hard water which does not produces lather. Yes? Okay. So, in other words, can I say कि if the water is soft, that means it will contain less quantity or less amount of calcium and magnesium salt? Yes, I can say. And when I use the word hard water, this means it is going to have higher content of dissolved calcium and magnesium salt. Yes, manenge na? Okay. So this property, that means the lathering of soap basically is nothing but hardness. Okay. So what happens? Aapne dekha hoga when the water is hard, you see the formation of a scummy white precipitate. If the water is hard. It is because of the formation of scummy white precipitate. Okay, So the hardness in water is attributed to the presence of calcium and magnesium. Salts बोले मैंने. Calcium sulfate, it can be ना calcium, magnesium sulfate, chloride, carbonates and bicarbonates. Fine. So we have so many things: calcium sulfate, calcium chloride, magnesium sulfate, magnesium chloride. Then calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate, magnesium bicarbonate and calcium bicarbonate. So there are many salts which has been responsible for the hardness of water. इसमें से एक भी पानी रहेगा, एक भी salt रहेगा पानी में, so that will cause what? Hardness of water. Okay, fine. So we know there are two types of hardness: temporary hardness and permanent hardness. Please, बहुत important है ये याद रखिएगा. Temporary hardness को हम बोलते हैं, इसका दूसरा नाम है carbonate hardness. इसका एक और नाम है, इसको हम बोलते हैं alkaline hardness. याद रखिएगा please. Alkaline hardness. ठीक है. Another word, alkaline hardness. So this hardness is because of the presence of calcium and magnesium carbonates and bicarbonates. So it can easily be removed by simply boiling. देखिए मैंने यहाँ लिखा हुआ भी है कि it is known as alkaline hardness as well. So calcium and magnesium रहेगा, इसको अगर heat करेंगे तो हम क्या देखते हैं, CaCO3 है, वो precipitate हो जाता है, right? Okay. So this hardness can easily be removed. ये PPT बन जाएगा, इसको हम filter करेंगे तो this will be easily removed. So we can easily remove the temporary hardness by boiling. So when we talk about the other hardness, that is permanent hardness. So hardness do tarah ki hai, permanent hardness and temporary. Temporary is because of the presence of calcium and magnesium, salt of carbonate and bicarbonate. Whereas permanent hardness, which is also known as non-carbonate, which is also known as non-alkaline. Non-alkaline. Hardness, okay. It is because of the presence of chloride, sulfates, phosphates and nitrates of calcium and magnesium salts, and it cannot be removed by boiling. So they require special methods like lime soda, zeolite and ion exchange process. So this is known as non-alkaline hardness. So आसानी से निकलता नहीं है. इसको remove करने के लिए we need to go with other processes. For example, the lime soda process का equation मैंने लिखा है. Calcium chloride अगर Na2CO3 से react करेगा, you will see the formation of CaCO3, which is nothing but a precipitate. Okay, so we are removing what? The permanent hardness with the help of lime soda process here. Then this is lime soda process. Let's talk about zeolite process. This is calcium sulfate. I am using different salt. This is zeolite, formula of zeolite. So what is here? Exchange of ion basically takes place. Yes, exchange of ion हो गया actually. तो Na2SO4 बन गया, CA जाके इसके साथ attach हो गया. So this remains onto the zeolite bed and you get the water which is free from calcium salt. Calcium ही नहीं रहेगा तो hardness ही नहीं रहेगा. Okay, then okay fine. So this was all about hardness. Okay, now when we talk about hardness, so we need to define the units also. Units of hardness. So there are different units of hardness. They are as follows, and it is very much important from your Viva point of view. Parts per million, milligrams per liter, degree Clark and degree French. Okay? Parts per million is what? 1 ppm is equal to 1 part of CaCO3, which is present in 10 to the power 6 parts of water. Aapko ye sab yaad rakhna hai. 1 mg per liter, you know, 1 mg of CaCO3. Equivalent hardness present in 1 liter of water. Degree Clark is what? 1 part of CaCO3 present in 70,000 parts of water. And what is degree French? It is 1 part of CaCO3 present in 10 to the power 5 parts of water. So, सबसे important, हम जो इस्तेमाल करते हैं ना, we use ppm and mg per liter. तो ये याद रखना है, 1 mg per liter equals to 1 ppm. This is our key. ये बहुत important है, इसको भूलना नहीं है, बाकी का नहीं भी याद रहा तो चलता, लेकिन ये आप याद रखेंगे दोनों को. ठीक है, सो हियर वी हैव गिवन द रिलेशनशिप हाउ द थिंग्स इज बीन फॉर्म्ड. सो नॉट इन योर सिलेबस, सो नीड नॉट बॉदर अबाउट दिस, बट प्लीज याद रखिएगा कि हार्डनेस ऑफ वाटर इज ऑफ, यू कैन डिफाइन द हार्डनेस इन 4 वेज. फर्स्ट इज पार्ट पर मिलियन, सेकेंड इज मिलीग्राम्स पर लीटर, थर्ड इज डिग्री क्लार्क एंड फोर्थ इज डिग्री फ्रेंच. ठीक है, समझ में आया? ओके, एंड 1 mg पर लीटर इक्वल्स टू 1 ppm. क्लियर? नाउ अब यहाँ एक नई चीज देखी होगी आपने, हर जगह मैंने CaCO3 लिखा है, हर जगह. कैन यू सी CaCO3 हियर, एवरीवेयर CaCO3. व्हाई CaCO3? क्यों CaCO3 ले रहे हैं? सो व्हाई हार्डनेस इज ऑलवेज बीन एक्सप्रेस्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ CaCO3 इक्विवेलेंट? बिकॉज़ Because it is the most insoluble and easily precipitable salt. सबसे ज्यादा इंसॉल्युबल है और आसानी से उसका पीपीटी बनाया जा सकता है. वाह वाह क्वेश्चन, बार बार नहीं बताऊंगी मैं, सुन लीजिए आप भी अच्छे से. सेकेंड थिंग इज कि मॉलिक्यूलर वेट इज 100. यू नो व्हाट इज मॉलिक्यूलर वेट, ना बताया था मैंने लास्ट क्लास में भी, लास्ट सेम में. एंड इक्विवेलेंट वेट इज 50. सो इट्स अरिथमेटिक कैलकुलेशन इज वेरी मच इजी. सो वी कैन ऑलवेज गो विद द कैलकुलेशन विद 100. 100 से कैलकुलेशन करेंगे तो अरिथमेटिक कैलकुलेशन इज इजी. दैट्स व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग CaCl3 इक्विवेलेंट ऑलवेज. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ वाटर. पोटेबल वाटर जो हम पीते हैं, इट शुड बी फ्री फ्रॉम कलर, ओडर, बैक्टीरिया एंड डिसॉल्व गैसेस, राइट. It should have pleasant taste. Okay. Then dissolved content should be below 10 ppm. Chloride content should be below 250 ppm. Fluoride content should be below 1.5 ppm. And the hardness should be below 500. क्योंकि इसके ऊपर रहा तो hard water हो जाएगा. इसलिए हमको soft water चाहिए ताकि हम हमारे कपड़े अच्छे से धो सके और हमारे घर में जो दाल बनती है ना वो गल जाए. दाल अगर नहीं गली इसका मतलब water is hard. दाल गल गई मतलब water is soft. And the pH should be between 6.5 to 8. Yes, हमारे पास जो पानी रहता है, it is slightly you can say alkaline in nature. Right? तो ये just a requirement है. You should be, because being an engineer, you should know the characteristics or the requirement of a potable water. Henceforth, I have shared this slide with you. So that's all, dear students, and that's all we have for today's class. In tomorrow's class, I'll be continuing with this lecture only. For the reference, I've been using Dara, Jain and Jain, and requesting you to go with the notes which I'm going to give you in printed form. Okay. God bless you. Have a nice day. Stay happy. Stay blessed. Be safe. Please mark your attendance in your Google form, which will be shared with you shortly in your WhatsApp group. Thank you so very much.